Greetings, Guardians. My name is Bife here. So, Destiny teaser for the next reveal of The Taken King has just dropped. Mr. Fruit, of course, is going to be joined by James Tsai, one of the design leads, and they're going to be taking on the Shield Brothers. It's a strike set within the Dreadnought, and it's against the Cabal. Nice, because we haven't seen too many Cabal-based strikes. We have Valus Tuaric, and then we have the, well, Dust Palace. And let's be frank, both of those aren't great strikes. And also one of them, of course, was an exclusive, so not many people have tried it. So for a lot of you, it will only have been one Cabal strike. But anyway, let's jump into this teaser, let's break down all of the important points. So, first of all, here. This is probably one of the most important things we've seen thus far. Nolan North as the Ghost. I'm just gonna let this play for you guys.
Why do you think they crashed their ship into the Dreadnought? Those are extreme tactics for the Cabal.
Indeed, it is a bold move even for the Cabal. Tell me what you guys think of Nolan North's voice acting in the comments section below. I personally think that the kind of more professor-like and dainty voice actually does suit as a good kind of parallel to our Guardians, you know? You have almost kind of an Alfred to the Batman type thing going on there, and I think that's actually pretty good. In the meantime, though, at the very end of that cutscene, there is a massive explosion. Now, we see from the later description of the strike, as it's shown on the map of the Dreadnought, and also as it's shown in the quest log, that the Cabal Shield Brothers are out to destroy the Dreadnought's core. Do you guys reckon that this is actually, a sign of their progress, and therefore this potentially could be a cinematic that we find in the strike, or do you think this is just another part of a story mission which is also related to the Cabal and it just leads up to it? I'm not personally sure, but I'd like to get your thoughts on that as well, so again, tell me in the comments section below. Now here we get a shot of the beachhead made by the Cabal. Essentially, what's happened here is they've crashed their ship, the Denylian Exodus 6, into the side of the Dreadnought in order to make that beachhead. And the beachhead is being established there so that they do have a chance of destroying that core. The Cabal here are from the Skyburners Legion, an elite force. You're talking about the guys who were also around Valus Tuaric, so expect some really nasty gunplay with these guys. They know what they're doing. Next up here, we have the most important thing in all of this, the map of the Dreadnought. And there's a whole host of different icons here, so let's go over them. 5 story mission icons, 2 strikes, the patrol, and the raid. Personally, I think 5 story missions is a tad disappointing, but I do also want to hold back on its judgments ever so slightly, because also it's meant to be something to do with quests. That means that not every single story mission is going to be a thing. You can have quests that are located on the Dreadnought, which are just completely separate and run outside of the story missions altogether. So maybe it's the case that those are actually just, like, not as important as they appear. However, I would still be a little bit disappointed if there wasn't a whole host of other story missions in other destinations, you know? You had House of Wolves, which was shot across basically Earth and Venus, and, well, frankly, if you didn't get at least multiple planets in there, I know we're going to Phobos, then it does feel a little bit disappointing. I want to be able to go ahead and say that this expansion does have a lot of story, and if there are other mission nodes in other areas, then yes, it does. But at this current point, if it's 5 story missions on the Dreadnought alone, just for this one expansion, maybe that's okay. I'm not 100% sure. They did guarantee us that the story would take 6 to 7 hours within its just first opening act before it opened up to Act 2, which includes the strikes, the sort of general questing in random areas, and of course the raid. So, who knows how the story is going to work out? It doesn't instill much confidence in me, but honestly, I still have a little bit of faith, so I'm not going to do any judgments here and now. Call me what you will for that. Also, it's well worth noting that from these mission nodes, we can see several things. So, one story mission is confirmed to start near the Hull Breach, one story mission is set on the Denylian Exodus 6, one story mission is set in the Mausoleum, one story mission is set in the Founts, and one story mission is set at the Altar of Oryx. I'd expect that to be the final base story mission of The Taken King, but I'm not 100% sure. Patrol missions will start in the Hull Breach, quite logically. You need to come in from the outside of the Dreadnought. It doesn't make any sense to start right in the damn middle of the thing. I mean, it is a fortress. And of course, the Darkblade Strike is located there in the Hanging Crypt. Makes a little bit of sense, seeing as Alakhal is supposed to have been imprisoned there for all of eternity for disobeying Oryx and starting a Hive Civil War. So, yeah, makes sense that he's in a hanging crypt of some kind, a prison almost. And finally, the Shield Brothers strike is located in a location known as the Narthex, up in the north of the Dreadnought. And, well, here's a shot of the Narthex. This is the place where you're going to face the Shield Brothers, and given the description of their mission, which is to destroy the central power core of the Dreadnought and thus destroy it, I would think that they are actually in the central power core's area, so perhaps the Narthex is the place where the Dreadnought is powered from. And it kind of lends to this idea with this massive circular structure over here. Also, finally, we have these shots of the Shield Brothers and their weapons and abilities. Now, one of them is going to be armed with this massive melee weapon over here, and you have a second one who is armed with a massive mortar cannon. Now, the reason they're called the Shield Brothers is because of the fact that they can both throw up a personal dome shield that's rather large. Think of it as a giant Ward of Dawn. Throw that thing up, and I'm not sure what the effects are, but my assumption is entering it will debuff you, you will not be able to damage them from outside, and each of them will have separate effects, which means that their particular weapon is just deadlier when you're inside that particular bubble of theirs. I'm not 100% sure how this works, again, I'll be 100% honest, so we shall see what happens in the livestream tomorrow. But in the meantime, guys, one last thing, I understand I've already asked you lot for a whole bunch of things in the description and comments, but please, tell me if you want a mission detail on this particular strike. If you want me to go in further in depth and just explain everything that we know about it thus far before the Dreadnought thing drops. I do plan on doing a video on that if you guys want me to, so go ahead and like the video, I guess, if you want that. But also, if you want some more stuff on Xur and the Instagram posts that we saw yesterday, I've got a video coming up on that. For those of you who don't know, Xur on Instagram is going to reveal, as in the Destiny game Instagram, he's going to reveal some new Taken King exotics and stuff that we could see in the upcoming expansion. I'm going to go ahead and just talk about everything we see there, so think of it as a preview of all the exotics that we'll be getting. So, that's going to give you guys some nice video content to hold you over until the stream tomorrow. I really hope you're enjoying all this. This is a big push, and I want to make sure that I can give you guys the best content out there. In the meantime, guys, my name is Bife. Per audacia ad astra. I'll see you, Starside.